Okay, so this is my name, Vishnu Sharma. This is my email ID, vishnu.etltrainer@gmail.com. And this is my contact number. And the course duration will be for 5 weeks. Okay, so in the ETL testing, we will see this syllabus. The syllabus contains data warehouse, SQL. Just a minute, few people have came. Let me allow them. Yes. Okay. It will have data warehouse, SQL, Informatica, QC Center, scheduling tool for ETL testing. What is scheduling tool? There is nothing like a software. That's the way how we used to schedule the ETL testing. And thereafter, we will cover two projects. Okay. So, what we are going to cover in the data warehouse. In the data warehouse, we will cover what is data warehouse, what is the purpose of data warehouse, what is ETL, overview of ETL operation, ETL architecture, data mart, types of data mart versus data warehouse, what is dimension table, types of dimension table, what is fact table, types of fact table, what is OLAP, OLTP, OLAP versus OLTP, data modeling, and the most important topic is star schema, snowflake schema, normalization and denormalization. These are the most important topic. And over here only we will see what is SCD. SCD is slowly changing dimension and their types. Okay, and what are the uses of SCD and the surrogate key. These are the topics we are going to cover in the data warehouse. Apart from that, in the SQL, in the SQL, we will see the history of SQL introduction. Thereafter, we will cover data definition language, data manipulation language, transactional control language, DCL, data types, aggregate function, different types of join, case statement, rank, pseudo rank, and this complete syllabus. Apart from this, this SQL contains this one also. Okay, the uses of SQL query, what is view with real-time example. Okay, and apart from this, here the hero comes, that is Informatica. Informatica ETL2. So what we are going to cover in the Informatica ETL2? Here we will cover Power Center Designer, Power Center Workflow Manager, Power Center Workflow Monitor, Mapping, Workflow, Sessions. Okay. And apart from that, the most important topics in the Informatica is aggregate transformation, filter transformation, expression transformation, router, joiner, sequence generator, lookup, and ETL test environment. What is ETL tester strategy? Then ETL testing methodology, ETL tester technique, ETL functional testing, ETL performance testing, thereafter introduction to slowly changing dimension. Because in a brief, we will see what is SCD, we will see in the data warehouse only. So here I will give you the introduction part only. Okay. So apart from this, I will cover after the completion of course, I will show you the QC tools and I will help you in building the resume also. Okay. So now we are going to start the class, that is for the data warehouse, this data warehouse. Let me share the new slide. Yes. Whether my new slide is visible to everyone? Okay. Yeah. Someone is talking. I'm not getting his voice. If I'm unable to respond them, then please message me. Definitely after the class, I will respond. Okay. If you have any question, tell me. Your voice is becoming very feeble. Can you please bit louder or can you please bring the mic to your mouth?
Could you please change the screen background blue to some other color?
Bluetooth, some other color. Are you using mobile?
Yes, a mobile.
Yeah, that's it. Okay, it is completely set for today. It will take time to change the color. Just a minute, let me change the color, background color. Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So, now we are going to start data warehouse. So, from the word warehouse, it is very clear that warehouse means storage and data warehouse means the place where we use to store the data. Okay, a data warehouse is a database used for the reporting. A data warehouse is a subject-oriented, integrated, time-variant, and non-volatile. Subject-oriented means what? A data warehouse can be utilized to analyze subject area. For example, sales data, finance data, or any data. Okay. Integrated means what? A data warehouse integrates data from multiple data sources. Time-variant. Time-variant means historical data is kept in a data warehouse. For example, anyone can retrieve the data from 6 months, 3 months, 12 months, or even older from a data warehouse. Being an ETL tester, you will always deal with the historical data. Historical data means what? Whatever the sales has been happened till yesterday, you people will deal with those data only. Okay, now coming towards the point, non-volatile. Non-volatile means what? Once a data is in the data warehouse, it will not change. So before uploading the data into the data warehouse, you have to make sure that whatever the data is uploaded by you, it is a proper data. So how to make a proper data? That we will see during practical. Okay, so historical data in a data warehouse should not be altered. You are not supposed to alter those data which you have already uploaded into the data warehouse. Okay, now we will see the difference. What is the difference between data warehouse and web application project lifecycle? Normally, any project starts with the requirement and ends with the data. But in the data warehouse project starts with data and it ends with the requirement. All the data warehouse are database, but all the database are not data warehouse. Why? We will see in detail in the below slide today only. Basically, a database is in any system which makes the data in a table format. A data warehouse is a specially set up database designed to hold large amount of data for reporting purpose. Okay, so there are few types of database. That is, one is normal database. Normal database is optimized for transactional activity for keeping a small amount of data. Now, a data warehouse will optimized for a large scale of reporting. When a data warehouse data from several systems will typically merge to present a global enterprise view. And it will also typically keep a very long history from several years to entire life of the company so that very long term trends can be viewed. You can save that much of data from the birth of company till last time of the company. Because historical data is the backbone of any business for mission critical business decision. Any company will lose anything, but they will not lose their data. For any company, it is very easy to lose their employees. They will do layoff, but they will not lose their data. Why? Because that is the backbone of any company and you people will deal with that data. So you have to make sure that data is very proper before uploading the data into the data warehouse. So how to make a proper data, that we will see during SQL classes. Now here the question is, why BI people or the BI systems are using data warehouse? Why you people are using data warehouse? Why anyone is using data warehouse rather than a normal database? With the help of normal database also, you can put the historical data. What makes the difference between the database, data warehouse, while both of them have the same ideas, both of them have the same feature. In both of them, we can store the data, we can store the indexes, we can store the constant. Then why you will use the data warehouse in place of normal database? Here, we will see the difference, why we are using. Normally, a normal database is used for online transactional processing. Online transactional processing is called OLTP. What is OLTP? That we will see in the below slide. Okay, this records the data from the user history. And the tables and joins are very complex in the normal database since they are normalized. This is done to reduce redundant data and to save storage space. Normal database generally follows ER modeling techniques for designing the database. It is optimized for write operation. And the performance of the normal database is very low compared to data warehouse. What are the advantages of data warehouse over normal database? The data warehouse is used for OLAP. OLAP means what? Online analytical processing. This reads the historical data for the user for business decision. The tables and joins are very simple compared to normal database. Why? Because they are denormalized. This is done to reduce the response time from analytical queries. And the dimension modeling techniques are used for the data warehouse design. It is optimized for read operation. That's why it's having very high performance for analytical queries. Just a minute. Yeah, Ramesh, we will get back after the class. So what is data mart over here? So a data mart is a specific subject-oriented repository of data designed to answer a specific question for specific set of users. So an organization should have multiple data mart serving the needs of the sales, like marketing, sales, etc. What is data mart? Just imagine that you are working in a company. Okay, so in your company, there are so many departments. HR department, finance department, sales department, networking team department, security department. Like this, there are so many departments. So each and every department will keep their data to somewhere. Okay, so that place is called as a data mart. And those people are storing their data only. Means the HR is HR team is storing the HR data. Finance team is storing only finance data. Security team is dealing with the security data. Network team is dealing with the network data. Okay, so every department is dealing with their own data. So that data will be called as a data mart. Okay, and definitely there will be some place where this all team will keep uploading their data in the company's database. So you can see that place is called as a data warehouse. Okay, so in another word, you can say data warehouse is a combination of data mart. But, or you can say data mart can be called as a data warehouse. Why? Because it is storing, this is also storing the data. But the data warehouse will not call as a data mart. You can call data mart as a data warehouse, but you can't call data warehouse as a data mart. Okay. Yes. Now we will see what is the difference between data mart versus data warehouse. A data mart stores the departmental data. A data warehouse stores enterprise data. A data mart is designed for middle management, and the data warehouse is designed for the top level management. Okay, a data warehouse is a single organizational repository enterprise wide data across many or all subjects area. A data warehouse incorporates information about many subject areas like sales, marketing, networking team, HR team, finance team, like this. Okay, so these all are the details. So each department has its own specific user for data mart, which is often ignored the information needs of some areas. It means what? Just imagine that you want some finance data. So definitely you will not go to the HR team, or you will not go to the networking team. You will contact the finance team only. So like this. Okay, so a data mart is typically easier to build rather than data warehouse. A data mart can be quickly implemented and offers fast access for the user. Okay, so since long time we are talking about OLAP, OLTP, OLAP, OLTP, normal database, data warehouse. What's the actual difference we will see now? Okay, so the features of OLTP systems are OLTP. Just a minute, someone has entered. Yes. The OLTP system handles day-to-day transaction and operation of the business. And OLTP system stores update and retrieve operational data. The operational data is a data that runs the business. Can you please mute whoever is there? Just a minute. Yep, thank you.
Yep.
Just a minute. Yeah. Features of.
Hello.
Yeah. Tell me.
Mr. Sir, in the part of the syllabus, Unix also there in part
of the syllabus? Yeah, Unix is also there. Very basic. Means what is required for the ETL tester. The very basic concept of Unix is required. That too will get covered.
We are not using in Unix in project.
No, we have to use. We have to use. Means not too much. Using
in project,
very, very rare. Very rare we are using. The Unix is only used for copying and pasting. Once in a use in a 6 month. Not frequently. Once in a month or once in a 3 month you will use that.
Okay.
So can you please mute yourself? Okay. So now we will see the difference between OLTP and OLAP. The difference, sorry, let me mute everyone. Yes, thank you. Now we will see what is the difference between OLTP and OLAP. Since long time we were talking about the OLTP and OLAP. Now here I will explain it. The response time of OLTP is seconds to seconds, but the response time of data warehouse is second to minute. In OLTP, you can only store 30 to 60 days of data, or max to max 1 year to 2 years old data. But in data warehouse, you can store even 1 year old data, 2 year old data, 10 year old data, 20 year old data, even decade and decades old data, 40 years old data, 50 years old data. So till that time, that much data you can store. So you can imagine what's the capacity of data warehouse. Okay. OLTP, it deals with the current data, and OLAP, it deals with the historical data. You people will deal with the historical data. Why? Because you are working on the data warehouse. In the interview, they can ask, you people are dealing with the current data or historical data? They never say that you will deal with the current data. Always say that we are dealing with the historical data. So coming towards the size of OLTP is from MB to GB, but the size of the data warehouse is from GB to TB. And OLTP is used for processing and OLAP is used for analysis. So OLTP, it will give you one record at a time, but in a data warehouse, you can get thousands to millions of records at a time. There are some drawbacks of data warehouse, but there are some features of in data warehouse and the features. So any doubt for this? Just a minute.
Hello, Vishnu sir.
Yeah, tell me.
What is the difference between database and OLTP?
Yeah, definitely we will see. Just a minute. Just a minute. Yeah, normal database and data warehouse, you mean to say. What is the difference between normal database and data warehouse? In normal database, you can store only very small amount of data, up to 30 days to 60 days or max to max 1 year old data. Okay, but in the data warehouse, you can store till 40 years or 50 years of old data.
Historical purpose.
Yeah, in the historical purpose. So, yes. And the capacity of data warehouse is very high compared to normal database. The response time of data warehouse is much better. In normal database, you can see it will show you one record at a time, but in the data warehouse, it will show multiple records at a time. There are so many differences over there. So in the coming slides, in the next classes, we will see in detail.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
So now coming towards the data modeling. So what is data modeling? Data modeling is nothing. It is a process of designing database with a set of table. A data warehouse is designed with the following types of schema. That is star schema and snowflake schema. Just now before starting the meeting, I was showing you the syllabus and there only I had told regarding star schema and snowflake schema that these are the important topics. Okay, so now we will see what is star schema and what is snowflake schema. Now before starting the star schema, I will tell something about the dimensional data model. Okay, a dimensional data model is often used in a data warehouse system in designing data models for data warehouse, data marts, and the most commonly used schemas are star schema and snowflake schema. Okay, so coming towards the star schema. In the interview, they can ask that which schema you are using in your project. Then you have to tell you are using star schema. Okay, why? Because 90% of your organization, they are using the star schema. And 10% of the organization, they are using the snowflake schema. Okay, so what is star schema? Well, star schema is nothing. It is a centrally located fact table and it is surrounded by the dimension table. Star schema looks like a star, so that's why it is called a star schema. A star schema is a database which contains centrally located fact table, which is surrounded by the dimension table. A star schema can be complex or it can be simple. Here you can see in this structure, this is the structure of the star schema. Okay, so this is the fact table and this is the dimension table. You can see this is the fact table is surrounded by the multiple dimension table. In a star schema, the fact table is surrounded by the multiple dimension table. Multiple dimension table means it could have two dimension table, it could be 3, 4, 5, 7, 10, 12, it could be anything. It is not mandatory that you will get only four dimension table. It could be anything. Okay. So now the next thing, you can see I had marked one arrow line between this time dimension and fact table. Means this fact table and dimension table. There is a line which is attached. So what does this line indicates? This line indicates that there is a relationship between this dimension table and this fact table. If there is no line over here or no line over here, it means there is no relation between this fact table and this dimension table. Okay, so what is star schema? Star schema is nothing. It is a centrally located fact table which is surrounded by multiple dimension table. The structure of a star schema is look like a star, so that's why it is called as a star schema. Okay, so now any doubt for the star schema?
Okay. In star schema, we are using in project, sir.
Yeah, we are using in the project. We are using the star schema in the project.
How can you find out star schema and snowflake schema?
That will be mentioned in the BRD document. That will be mentioned in the BRD document. And what is fact table? What is dimension table? That we will see now only.
Okay. Every star schema, only one fact table. They are one
exactly.
More.
Only one fact table. Only one fact table. That is called star schema. If it is more than that, that is different thing. That is not star schema. Star schema will have only one fact table.
Thank you, sir.
Might be due to something, the meeting can get disconnected due to 40 minutes of limit. So if it is getting disconnected, then again we will reconnect it and we'll continue the meeting. You can click on the same meeting link. Okay, if it is getting disconnected, then. Okay, so just now we have seen about the star schema. What is snowflake schema? A snowflake schema is nothing. It is the extension of the star schema. A snowflake schema is nothing. It is an extension of the star schema. Here, there will be one fact table and it will be surrounded by multiple dimension table. Okay, and that dimension table is attached with the other dimension table. Snowflake schema is what? Snowflake schema is nothing. It is an extension of the star schema. It will have one fact table and multiple dimension table. And that dimension table is attached with the other dimension table. And you can see over here also, there is a line which is connected between this dimension table and this dimension table. This arrow line indicates that there is a relation between this table and this table. Again, you can see a line is connected between this dimension table and this fact table. It means there is a relation between this table and this table. Okay, you can see this table is not connected with this table. This dimension table is not connected with this dimension table. It means there is no relation between this table and this table. The arrow line indicates that there is a relation between this dimension table and this dimension table. And this is called the fact table. So snowflake schema is what? Snowflake schema is, it is an extension of the star schema. It will have one fact table and multiple dimension table. And that dimension table is attached with the other dimension table. Somewhere you will see that in a snowflake schema, there will be more than one fact table. Okay, so that is not called a snowflake schema. That is called as complex snowflake schema. So in the interview, don't get confused that if they will say, if there is more than one fact table in a snowflake schema, then what it will be called as? Is it a snowflake schema? Then don't get confused, just tell them that is a complex snowflake schema. Snowflake schema will always have one fact table and multiple dimension table, and those dimension table are attached with the other dimension table. Okay, any doubt for this? Okay, So coming towards the fact table. What is fact table? Since long time we are discussing about the fact table, dimension table, fact table, dimension table. Now we will discuss what is fact table. A fact table is a central table in a star schema of a data warehouse. A fact table consists of fact of particular business, example sales, revenue, month by product or anything. A fact table will always have a numerical value. It will never have a alphabetical values. This is the structure of the fact table. You can see ID, all are numerical. Contact number, all are numerical. PIN code, all are numerical only. So a fact table will always have a numerical values. It will never have the